Good morning, dear students. Today we are going to start our social studies class with chapter 6, Greenland, the land of ice and snow. Dear students, in previous class we already discussed about many things about Greenland, like Greenland's vegetation, Greenland climate, Greenland's location. In today's class we will discuss about the remaining points, like whatever remains is there. First point is your wildlife. Dear students, before starting wildlife point, I want to discuss with you about wildlife. If we can, in the last class we already discussed that the Greenland is fully covered with ice and snow, then normal animal couldn't survive on that place, because in summer is also maximum temperature is about 5 degrees Celsius and minimum is about minus 23 degrees Celsius, and on that type of temperature, on that type of climate, a normal animal couldn't survive. For that thing, for surviving on that type of place, a special adaptation is also there on that animals. We will discuss about an adaptation in this wildlife point. Wildlife, most of the animals found in Greenland have fur. Most of the animals found in this Greenland have fur on their body to protect themselves from harsh winter climate. We know that Greenland is fully experienced harsh winter climate whole of the year. Because of protecting from harsh winter, the animals whichever found there have fully covered their body with fur. Some of the animals found in the island include reindeer. Which animal? Reindeer, polar bear, caribou, mink, muskox, arctic fox, arctic voles, and seals. These are the important animals which ever found in Greenland. Now we will talk about birds. Which type of birds are there in Greenland? Then seabirds. Which type of birds? Seabirds such as petrels, gulls, and puffins are found in Greenland. Only this type of seabirds are available. Seabirds are found in the Greenland area, because other birds couldn't survive on that type of climate, on that type of condition or temperature. The sea around Greenland is home to many species of fish. The sea around the Greenland is the main home of many type of species of fish. Many type of species of fish are available on that type of fish, like trout, salmon, and cod. This type of species and many another type of species are also available on that ocean or sea economy. Dear students, as we know that the Greenland is fully covered with ice and surrounded by ocean or sea, so we can say that it's fully dependent on sea industry, like the fishing industry. So we can say that the main occupation of the people in Greenland is fishing. Main occupation of the people of the Greenland is fishing. They are dependent on fishing products, because of the exporting the fishing products to another countries, like canning process and many type of fish preservative. They are preserving fish and after that they are selling to exporting to another countries, and that is the main occupation of that people. Because of that they are getting money. So the economy of the country depends upon fishing industry. We can say that the economy of the country is fully dependent. We can say that the country's economy is fully dependent on which industry? Fishing industry. Apart from fishes, the island exports minerals. Apart from fishes, excepting fishes industry, fishing product, they are exporting minerals also. Like which mineral? Lead and zinc. Both minerals are exporting to other countries from Greenland. Agriculture is practiced on a small scale. Agriculture is also practiced there. We know that the area of Greenland is fully covered with ice and thick ice sheet. Many type of icebergs are also we can found in the seas. So it is not possible to doing agriculture practices on that places. But in the summer season, the little sunrise is also we can watch. Their temperature is near by 5 degrees Celsius. Then on that time they are start to agriculture practices on a small area, and on that time they are growing vegetables and some other type of plants on that area. Transport. If transport point is there, then student main thing is here sledges. sledges are the common mode of transportation in the island. If we talk about Greenland, then you have to remember one point. If transportation system is being calling there, if anyone asks you about the transportation system in the Greenland, then you have to remember one point only, that is sledges. Sledges is the common modes of the transport whichever used in the whole of the Greenland, and it is drawn by the two animals. Like these sledges are drawn by huskies and reindeers. Dear students, you already know about the reindeer. Reindeer means yak like ox like animals, but huskies, it is new words to you, so I want to explain this word. Huskies means a type of a dog that's also drawn sledges. Here is already mentioned here, huskies are a type of a dog. Modern means of transport are also found in coastal areas. Dear students, we know that they have to make a transportation system easy for exporting their products to another countries. Like they are on the, for that thing they are using to making roads nearby the coastal areas for making easily transportation for the fishing products or lead and zinc exporting and many another thing exporting by them. That's making easy for they are now making roads also for transportation system. We can say that now they are also making modern transportation system for exporting and transporting. Kayak is a narrow boat. Dear student, kayak is a type of a boat whichever used for catching fish. It is an important point according to question answers also. Kayak is a narrow boat whichever used for the catching fish and made by skin of the sea and wood. Kayak is made by wood and seal skin. Used to catch fish, the umik is a larger boat, and umik is a larger boat. If anyone asks you about kayak and umik, then you have to remember one thing. Kayak is a boat whichever made by seal skin and wood and used to catching fish. And about umik, you have to remember one point only, that is a larger boat. Dear students, once again I am going to revise these points. Right, like most of the animals found in Greenland have fur because of protecting from opposite habitation. Like temperature is in down also, in summer also minus 23 degrees Celsius. For protecting from that type of temperature, that type of climate, they have fur on their body to protect themselves from harsh winter. Some of the animals found in the island include, which animals found on that island? Reindeer, polar bear, caribou, mink, musk ox, arctic fox, arctic balls, seals, and seabirds. Some birds are also there, like seabirds are present on that area, like petrels, gulls, and puffins are found in Greenland. And the sea around Greenland, the sea around Greenland is home to many species of fishes. Many species of fishes are also available on nearby the Greenland Sea, like trout, salmon, and cod. These are the fishes variety that's available in the Greenland. Economy. We already know that the main occupation of the Greenland people is fishing, and totally completely Greenland's economy is dependent on fishing industry. We can say that fishing industry is the backbone of the Greenland's economy. And excepting fishing industry, they are exporting like lead and zinc, some minerals also exporting by them. And on a small area, they are studying agriculture practices in summer time. These are the about the economy of the Greenland. And now about transportation. If transportation point is being here, then we have to remember one thing only. Sledges is the main mode of the transportation in the Greenland, whichever drawn by reindeer and huskies. Huskies are the type of a dog. And one more type of a boat is there, kayak. Kayak is a narrow boat whichever made by seal skin and wood, and generally used for catching fish. Kayak is used for catching fish. And the umik is a larger boat. Dear students, it's all about the wildlife, economy, and transport. Now we will discuss about the life of the people. How people live on that type of place, how their life, which type of clothes they wore, which type of life they have, which type of opposite condition also they face, how, which type of houses they have, in which type of houses they live, and much more things we will discuss in next point, the life of the people. Dear students, now we will talk about lifestyles of the Greenland people, which type of life they live, and many much more things. Lifestyle. the original inhabitants of the Greenlands are called Inuits. If anyone asks you about the original inhabitants of the Greenland, then you can say that Inuits are the original inhabitants of the Greenland. They time in snow houses called igloos, means mostly they live in the snow houses, that is known as igloos. Which type of houses? Snow houses, and that houses is known as igloos, means are made by dome shaped icebergs, and that type of house is known as igloos. Igloos is also called snow houses. The Inuits spread the skin of the animals on the floor of their houses, which protect from the opposite climatic condition. Means in their house they are using the animals' skins for spreading, like we are using carpets in our home. So they are using the animals' skin for spreading and for protecting from the opposite climatic condition, because temperature is too much harsh in the cold, so they couldn't survive on that type of condition. So they are using the skin of the animals for the floor. In the summer they live in the tents. In the winter they live in the igloos. In the summer they live in tents that is made of the skin of animals. The tent is made of the skin of the animals, and these tents are called taupiks. Tents are known as taupiks. The southwestern coast of Greenland is the warmest part of the country. Warmest part, which part? Southwestern part. Southwestern part of the Greenland is the warmest part of the country, so it is too much populous, many type of population. Mostly peoples are living in that part of the country. The people of Greenland use harpoons. What they are using? Harpoons and automatic rifles for hunting the fishes, seals, salmon, and many type of fishes. They are using that type of weapon, like harpoons and rifles. Fish is important part of their diet. We can say that because mostly they are dependent on fish, so we can say that they are dependent for their food on mostly on fish. Greenland is very cold place, so people wear clothes made of fur to which hood is attached. Means mostly people is also use that type of cloth which are made by the animal's skin and fully covered with animal's fur. We can say that their whole body of the Greenland's people is covered with furs, cloths, like a hand is covered with mittens, leg is covered with long shoes, and they are using the fur jacket for protecting himself from that type of opposite climatic condition. Many of them working in mines, mostly many of the persons are working in mines and oil fields. And now the people live in permanent houses. Now many types of changes took place in the Greenland. Now they are using to make permanent houses, and there is a schools also, hospitals also, and many markets is also going to establish now in these places. Now you can say that they are using permanent houses. The capital city Nuuk, we already described that thing in our last class. Capital of the Greenland is Nuuk, previously known as Gorthaf. Previously known as Gorthaf is a modern city and an important center for fish processing. Many type of fish canning and fish processing products is also exported from Nuuk to another part of the world. Once again, I am going to revise lifestyle. The original inhabitants of the Greenland are called Inuits. They live in the snow houses. Snow houses is known as igloos. The Inuits spread the skin of the animals on the floor. Means mostly they are using the skin of the animals for spreading on the floor for protecting themselves from the opposite climatic conditions. In the summer, they live in tents made of the skin of animals. In the summer, they are using tents for whichever they made by the animals' skin, that is known as taupiks. Most important point is here, the southwestern part of the Greenland. Which part? Southwestern part of the Greenland is warmest part of the country, so it is too much populous. Mostly population is lived in that place, and we can say that the people of the Greenland use harpoons and rifles to hunting the fishes, seals, and salmons, many types of animals. For hunting, they are using automatic rifles and harpoons. Fish is important part of their diet. they are mostly dependent on fish products, so we can say that fish is the important part of their fight. Their diet, without fish they couldn't survive, because there is no agriculture, no habitation is being there, then how can they survive? They are mostly dependent on fish only. And they, Greenland is very cold place, so people wear clothes made of fur. And ki Greenland is a too much cold place, so people of that places using fur cloths. Means mostly they are covering their whole of the body with fur cloth. Like even their hand is also covered with fur mittens, fur hand gloves and long shoes and fur jackets, and that type of clothes they are using, so much heavy clothes they are using on that time, because of they want to survive in the opposite climatic condition. And mostly we can say that many of them working in mines and oil fields. Now they are started to working in the mining areas and the oil fields. Now the people live in permanent houses. Before that they live in igloos and tow pits, but now they started to living in permanent houses, and now schools, banks and markets and many another facilities are also available on that area. The capital city Nuuk, previously known as Gartha, is a modern city now. Nuuk is a modern city now, and it is an important trading center for processing, fish processing and the fish canning industry, and for exporting fish products to another country. Dear students, in this chapter we discussed about many much more things about Greenland, how is it placed, and it is fully covered with snow, and which type of animal, which type of vegetation, which type of climate, which type of temperature, which type of people's life, many much more things we discussed already in this chapter, and I hope you understand it very well. Thank you.